We are less than 2 months away from the start of the 2017 state legislative session. What are your priorities for the coming year for the state of New York and your district?
Well, first of all, I think we're going to hold the Republican conference, which is extremely important for us to hold the majority. And I have to think that the Trump factor helped all the Republicans in the state of New York. And I was glad to have supported him publicly. And the other thing, but getting back to what we're going to do, we're going to continue to fight for lower taxes on the people in the state of New York. We can do more in that area. Even though our state tax rate is the lowest it's been in 70 years, even though our corporate tax rate has been the lowest in about 50 years, and our manufacturer's tax rate has been as a same historic amount of years, low. All positive because of what the Republican conference has done. In addition, we will continue to support all of our hospitals with new monies for technology and expansion. And we did that to a great extent in 2016. And we'll continue to try to improve the quality of health care under the leadership of Senator Kemp Hannon. In addition, we worked out the parity pretty well in terms of our transportation budget. New York City and MTA got fair funding for their needs, and we had a like amount for our bridges and roads for the island and upstate New York. The truth of the matter, Mark, is the Senate Republicans protect upstate. We're always fighting the regional politics. Because when the Democrats got in control in 29 and 2010, the monies for education, healthcare, transportation, they took 55% of the money, gave 45% to the island upstate. That was morally wrong. I'm not even going to talk about, yeah, I will, $13 billion new spending, about $9 billion in new taxes. So we're there to protect upstate. In addition, we will continue to fund tourism, which is extremely important to upstate, and it's about $50 million now. We will continue to fight that terrible heroin epidemic, which I was a member of the task force, led pretty much by Senator Murphy, where we funded it to the amount of $167 million. We're making a dent, but we got to do more. And the Environmental Protection Fund broke records this past year, $300 million. We'll continue to make sure there's sufficient money to protect our water and our air. And we'll continue, of course, our first priority is education, to make sure there's enough funding for quality of education. And I believe that we should allow the teachers and the local school districts to do more in evaluating our students rather than the Board of Education. Because the further you get away from the schools and where people live and work and teach, it's not as efficient. And it doesn't promote excellence in education when you take it to a higher bureaucracy, whether it's the state or the federal. So I like local control. I like parental input. And I love the teachers who know how to teach.
Now, along with a great record of investing in your local schools, you also have a very strong record in proposing and fighting for property tax reform. Where do you see that going in the coming year?
Well, you know, it's still a Band-Aid approach. We do the tax cap, which has been good. We saved the taxpayers $7 billion since 2011. And we do give monies back in the STAR program. But I will continue to fight for structural changes of the way we fund education. We need a broader base tax, whether it's a part of the sales tax, whether it's a part of the income tax. I would love to see property taxes taken off the rolls to fund education. And it's something that I have been promoting and fighting for. In addition, I fight the abuses of tax exempts, which when I first started in 2004, I did a thesis on this for the legislature. There was $440 billion of tax-exempt properties. And when a piece of property is exempt, it doesn't go away, it passes on to the paying taxpayers. Today, based on the 2015 assessment, it's $880 billion and growing.
Wow.
So that's an area that cries out for reform. Another area that we protect is the agricultural industry. And we have come up with programs to try to help young farmers with grants, helping them with giving them some state lands to get started with agriculture. Because for every one young farmer, we have six older farmers. And it's our leading industry. And there are no farms in New York City, so the assembly, it's not a high priority. For the Democrats in the Senate, it's not a high priority because they're all pretty much from the metropolitan area. But for upstate, my district, it's a very high priority. And the governor every year cuts it. And I just want to tell you how bad he hits agriculture. I'm going to put my glasses on and read something to you. The Cornell onion research, he cut it all out. Cornell honeybee program, he cut it all out. Cornell vegetable research, he cut it all out. Christmas tree farmers, he cut it all out. Maple syrup research, he cut it all out. Deer fencing, maple products, farm viability, dairy profit teams. He cut wine and grape foundation. Berry Growers Association, totally out. Integrated Pest Management, totally out. Apple growers, he cut. He cut food hubs. And I can go on and on and on. But the reason I read all of this is to show you across the board, he swipes all of agriculture. And that was 30 programs to the tune of over $11 million. And we made sure in the budget when it was adopted, all of those programs were restored.
And I'm sure you'll be fighting it again this
Absolutely.
Coming year.
It's always a top priority for upstate, all of the senators, and on the island for agriculture.
Because all of this money, every dollar is so important in supporting the efforts so that people can start farms, can pass on farms, or diversify what they're doing on the farms.
And we want to make sure we eat healthy food that's locally grown, so it's all good. We don't like getting the food from foreign countries.
Well, we'll look forward to talking with you about this some more in our next show. Senator, thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much, Mark.
And thank you for watching.